I've got this web page with a picture of Onos, who is freaking out that the world is going to end soon, specifically in 500 seconds. I want to make this web page way more useful by turning this number into a live countdown so that visitors can see exactly how much time they have left. Now, when we animate part of a web page, the strategy is to find some element in it, then change something about that element, and do that a particular number of times a second. So for the first step, I will find the countdown by ID. Simple. So countdown equals document.getElementById countdown. For the second step, I'll make a function that counts down. Bar countdown equals function. And what we'll do is I want to set the text content, and I want to set it equal to the previous number minus 1. And the text content will actually be a string, so we want to turn it into a number. We can do that using parse float. And then we can subtract 1 from it. Okay, so finally, we want to call this function on an interval, which means a certain number of times per second. And we can use that using window.setInterval. And this function takes 2 arguments, the callback function and the number of milliseconds to wait before that function gets called back again. We can specify the callback function just like we specify it for event listeners by name. And then it's going really fast right now because we haven't specified the second argument. So for that, we want it to be a certain number of milliseconds, and we want it once per second, so we're going to say 1,000, because there are 1,000 milliseconds in a second. There we go. Now it's counting down 1 per second. So you better learn as much as you can in the next 490 seconds. There is one more window function that we sometimes use instead of set interval, and that's set timeout. And I'll just change it to that and see if you can see the difference. I have to wait a second. Okay, so now maybe you can see that when we use set timeout, the browser only calls the function once, not repeatedly. That's not so useful for when we're making animations, but it can be super useful in other cases, like if we showed a warning banner to our users and then we wanted to hide it after 10 seconds. So let me change this back to set interval. Now, when we're testing animations like this, we should really see what they look like at all points of the animation, like what happens when it gets down to 0. Well, that's going to take a really long time to get there, and you're going to get really bored. So we'll just change our beginning data to 5 and watch what happens. 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, negative 1, negative 2. Okay, so now it's getting weird. When the world ends, it should just go kaboom and stop counting. So what we actually want to do is stop this animation once it gets to that 0 point. And we can do that using an if condition inside the function. So let me start by storing the current time in a variable since we're going to use it a few times. So I'll just take this, put it here, and replace this with current time. And now what I can do is have an if condition that makes sure that we only update the text if current time is greater than 0. So that's the only time we want to actually subtract 1. So then we need to move this inside here. This works, but there is something really bad about this approach. The browser is still calling the counted down function once per second as long as this web page is open. You shouldn't make browsers call functions for no reason. They have lots of other important things to do. What we really want to do is to tell the browser that once it gets to 0, it doesn't need to call this function anymore at all. We can do that using a new method, window.clearInterval. We can stick that in this else here, window.clearInterval. Now, we need to pass it an argument so that it knows which interval to clear, because we might actually have multiple intervals on a page. The way that we know which interval to clear is to store the result of setInterval in a variable. So now I've got it in the timer variable. I can copy, paste it into there, and now it knows what to clear. So when it gets to zero, it should stop updating and it should stop calling that function. For every animation that you make, you should think carefully about what the condition should be for stopping it. And yes, you might have some animations that should go on and on, my friends, but they better be really sweet animations because your browser is working every time it calls that callback function. Now spin this off and make the world actually go kaboom.